Welcome to our search field introduction and tutorial for external data for Jira. In this video, we will guide you through the setup and configuration of a basic search. We then combine this search with an info panel, which allows us to select customers by name and display detailed information about them within a Jira issue. Before we begin, ensure you have a company managed project, a custom target field of the type text field, and a data source. We'll use the sample 1 data set provided by the app for demonstration purposes. You can generate this sample in the Settings tab. Let's start by adding a search field configuration. For the data source, select the earlier generated sample 1, all customers. Optionally, we could add a context filter for nested searches and field dependencies. Yet, we don't need this for our current purpose. Below, the JSON list content will be displayed. To configure the search, we select our data list using the JSON path. It is important to always select the entire list and not just a single value. Now we set up an ID field. The unique identifier helps us to identify an item within our dataset. Moving on to the search field, where we define the underlying field values we want to use as basis for the search. In our use case, we want to search for the name of a customer, so we add the corresponding JSON path. Field values always refer to the values in your data source. The value field determines the value that will be written in the Jira target field. In this use case, we'll go with the customer's name again. The value label can differ from the search field input and allows us to add descriptions or other values too. We can also add additional values if we want to make the search results more specific. Please make sure to add curly brackets if you enter more than one value. In the same way that you can customize the search output, you can individualize the appearance of your drop-down list with the search label option. You can either use JSON path expressions or mustache syntax here. Finally, we need to define a target Jira field where our search output will be displayed. Please note that the search field and the actual target field are two separate entities on your Jira output screen. Save and your search is all set to go. We now want to add an info panel with detailed information about the selected customer in our Jira issue. For this, we need to add another field configuration and choose info panel. For a detailed walkthrough, please see our info panel tutorial video, which we have linked in the description. In this video, we're going to do a configuration speed run. First, we're choosing our data source. Then we're adding a context filter to specify the relevant context for the info panel in reference to our search field. We are referencing the target field from our previous search. And finally, we need to customize and design our info panel. Once you are happy with the format and design, save and your info panel is all set to go. Now, let's see how our search with the info panel looks in a live Jira issue. Thanks for watching. For more information, check out our documentation, which is linked in the description. If you liked this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to get more updates and tutorials in the future.